In this video, we will learn how to align 2D and 3D objects with other objects using the Align and 3D Align tools. Let's start with the 3D Align tool, which is used exclusively in 3D modeling. Aligning 3D objects requires specifying 3 points on the object to be aligned and 3 points as destination points. These commands are especially useful when you want to move and rotate an object so one of its faces is tangent to another object's face. The 3D Align tool can be found in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type 3D Align in the command line and press Enter to activate it. Once the tool is active, I need to select the objects I want to align. So I will select the pyramid you see in the drawing area and press Enter. In the next step, I have to specify the base point. Before I do that, I should mention that if you select the copy option that can be seen in the command line, then the aligned object will be a copy and the original object will remain as it is. I will click on the pyramid's front left corner to specify the first base point. Then I need to specify the second base point, so I will click on the pyramid's front right corner. At last, I have to specify a third base point. The third base point will be the pyramid's back right corner. After specifying the 3 base points, I have to specify the 3 destination points. I will click on the first corner of the object's face to specify the first destination point. Then I will click on the second corner of the object's face to specify the second destination point. And finally, I will click on the third corner of the object to specify the third destination point. As soon as I defined the third destination point, the pyramid aligned with the other object and the tool deactivated automatically. At this point, I will move on to the next example to show you how the Align tool works. The Align tool requires specifying either 1, 2, or 3 pairs of source and definition points according to which the selected objects are moved, rotated, or tilted to be aligned with the other object. Each source point is aligned with the corresponding destination point. The Align tool can be used in either 2D or 3D objects and can be found in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Align in the command line and press Enter to activate it. Once the tool is active, I need to select the objects I want to align. So I will select the pyramid and press Enter. In the next step, I have to specify the first source point. I will click on the pyramid's front left corner to specify the first source point. Then I need to specify the first destination point, so I will click on the corresponding corner of the other object. Now I will specify the second source point, and I will match this point with the second destination point on the other object. At last, I have to define the third pair of source and destination points. So I will specify the third source point on the pyramid's back right corner and the third destination point on the corresponding corner of the other object. Once the 3 pairs of points are defined, the pyramid aligns with the other object and the tool deactivates automatically. It should be noted that by specifying 3 pairs of points, you practically define a plane. The Align tool, though, has another important feature. It can align an object and resize it at the same time. In this case, only 2 pairs of points need to be defined. However, the object is not aligned according to a plane, but according to the distance between the 2 destination points. To get a better understanding of what I mean, let's move on to the next example. I will activate the Align tool, select the pyramid, and press Enter. I will specify the first 2 pairs of source and destination points as I did in the previous example, but instead of specifying a third pair too, I will look at the command line. the message "Specify a third source point or continue" appears. To continue, I will press Enter. As soon as I press Enter, a new message appears asking me if I want to scale the object based on alignment points. I will select Yes and notice the result. As I mentioned before, the object is not aligned according to a plane since I did not specify the third pair of points. Its size, however, was adjusted according to the destination points. In the last example, I will show you how to align 2D objects. First, I will activate the Align tool. Then, I will select the rectangle and press Enter. I will click on the rectangle's lower left corner to specify the first source point. Then I will click on the corresponding point of the other object to specify the first destination point. Now, I will specify the second source point and I will match this point with the second destination point on the other object. When the message "Specify a third source point or continue" appears, I will press Enter. As soon as I press Enter, a new message appears asking me if I want to scale the object. I will select Yes and notice the result. At this point, I will undo the alignment to show you the result when I select not to scale the object. So I will activate the Align tool, select the rectangle, and press Enter. Then, I will specify the two pairs of source and destination points and press Enter. This time, in the next message, I will select No and notice the result. The rectangle was aligned with the shape, but it retained its original dimensions.